Jillian from the Center for Academic Communication. Welcome to Academic Language and Tone. Today we'll review some conventions of academic writing and the kinds of language and vocabulary that do and don't belong in an academic assignment. We'll go over a few essential features of academic writing, including some specific vocabulary and how to use hedging to convey different levels of probability and certainty. Although some features do vary between academic disciplines, engineering, of course, sounds different from English literature, many essential features are shared. Academic writing is different from speech and from most other types of writing that you might be used to. Every type of communication you do is about knowing your audience. For example, you probably don't talk to your grandmother exactly the same way you talk to your friends. In the same way, you can't write an academic assignment in your speaking voice. Academic writing is more specific, concise, and well-planned. In the sample text from Halliday, you'll notice that there are a lot more pronouns in the spoken text: that, this, they, and you. You'll also notice that the written text is shorter and more concise. In academic English, the use of the second person you voice should almost always be avoided. Depending on your discipline, the first person I, we, our, us voice should also be avoided or limited. These days, in many disciplines, it's acceptable to use I to talk about your intentions and findings, especially in your introduction and conclusion. But some disciplines prefer a more objective tone and may require that you leave it out completely. Contractions like don't aren't used in academic writing either. Always write out the full forms and don't use slang, idioms, or cliches. No one in your essay should ever be barking up the wrong tree or thinking outside the box. Also avoid language that's very general or vague. There's always a better, more accurate, and descriptive word than good or people. With quantities, be specific and use formal terminology. Avoid all variations of the word thing whenever possible. And imagine that writing the word stuff in an academic essay is like saying the F word in front of your grandma. If I did that, mine would stop giving me $10 for my birthday every year. There are also a few informal introductory phrases and words, like last but not least, besides, and first of all, that should be avoided. Another common problem is using on the one hand or on the other hand, but not both. There are two hands. This structure is also quite informal and should probably be avoided anyway. Also, try not to use phrasal verbs in academic writing. These are two or more word verbs that combine a verb and a preposition. Many of these combinations also contain a verb that has multiple meanings, such as have, do, get, and be, which can cause confusion. Instead, use a single specific verb. The good news is that there really aren't that many high-frequency academic verbs, so learning these thoroughly in all their forms is a valuable investment of your study or writing practice time. Finally, using intense or emotional modifiers does not make your arguments more convincing. Saying that something is great, terrific, tremendous, or the best will not convince an educated audience. And if you say that something is always or never true, you'll need to be 100% certain of this and use reliable evidence to support this claim. If you're not 100% sure, you can use hedging language. There's language for frequency, like often or rarely, for number, like most or few, verbs like seem and could, and modal adverbs and adjectives, like possible or clearly. Hedging language allows you to be cautious in your claims and therefore more credible. In the sample sentence without hedging, some readers might want to argue with you, but in the revised sentence with hedging, more readers would probably agree. Okay, that concludes academic language and tone. I hope you've learned a few tricks for writing like a good academic. Thanks for watching.
To learn more tips and tricks to help improve your academic communication skills, visit the University of Victoria Center for Academic Communication website for workshops and other resources. You can also book an appointment with one of our tutors by clicking the link in the description below. Good luck, and see you soon!